What's up, everybody? It's Greg, and today we're going to go over my beginner's guide to candle making. Everything you need to know if you're looking to start a candle making business or if you're looking to make candles for a hobby. All right, let's get right into it with safety. You're going to need gloves, an apron, ventilation, maybe a respirator, and a fire extinguisher. Candle making can be messy and you're dealing with chemicals, so you want to protect your skin and your clothes. You also want to be working in a well-ventilated area. If you don't have a well-ventilated area, you're going to want to look into getting a respirator. And last but not least, you're going to need a fire extinguisher. You're dealing with fire in the home, and it's always smart to have a fire extinguisher on hand. First thing you're going to need is wax. There's paraffin wax, soy wax, palm wax, coconut wax, all types of wax, plus all the blends in between. I suggest you try multiple waxes before you settle on your first big purchase. All right, next is wicks. Now, any wick will work with any wax. There are some wicks that might work a little better with certain waxes, but in general, all wicks are going to work with any wax. The most important part is to pick a series that you like and get a sample pack. That way you can wick test and go up or down without ordering more wicks and paying more shipping costs and waiting longer times. Have a sample pack on hand, so if your wick is too big, you can go down a notch. If your wick is too small, you can go up a notch instantly right away. Especially if you're doing wickless testing, it makes it a lot easier. And I have a video on that down at my channel, something like that. All right, next you're gonna need wick stickers. This is gonna secure your wick to the bottom of the jar. Some people use hot glue, but I prefer wick stickers because they're made for candle making. Fragrances. There are tons of different fragrances to choose from. My top five probably are gonna be Candle Science, Midwest Fragrance, Flaming Candle. That's only like three, but those are pretty good. Not sponsored by any of these people. For the money, those are actually really good places to get your fragrances from. You're gonna need a scale and a thermometer because this is science, and to make a candle properly, it needs to be precise. It's gonna be like making a loaf of bread where the recipe needs to be the same every single time so you can get the same effect during the burn. There are a couple different kinds of thermometers you can get. They have the stick thermometer and the digital thermometer, but I prefer the infrared thermometer. It's the infrared heat gun thermometers, because one of the most important temperatures you're gonna need to take is your jar temperature. And you can only get that with your infrared heat thermometer. And you're gonna need a way to melt that wax. In the beginning, you should probably be using a double boiler. I don't suggest you use the microwave, even though that's been going around a lot of the Facebook groups lately. So a double boiler, that's just gonna be a pot and a melting pitcher, like this one. Now, if you want color, you might need some dye. There are a couple different dyes to choose from. There's liquid dyes, there's block dyes, there's dye chips. If you're using block dyes or dye chips, I suggest you add those while your wax is still heating. That way they properly dissolve in the wax. If you're using a liquid dye, you can add that pretty much at any time and it will dissolve evenly. And you'll need a wick centering tool. This is something to keep your wick straight up and down while it's cooling. Some people use chopsticks or pencils, but they actually make wick centering tools that are fairly cheap. I use a metal one and it works really good. So a wick centering tool is something you're gonna need to keep your wick centered in place while it's cooling. And last but not least, vessels. In the beginning, don't go crazy with vessels. I know you can go vessel shopping and get a ton of different vessels from a ton of different places, but it's harder than you think to actually wick those vessels. So I would go with something cheaper and smaller in the beginning. Now, they do have candle making kits, and those have pros and cons. And the pro is that it comes with everything and you can start making candles right away. And they're fairly cheap. The cons are that the materials are usually pretty crappy, and that can lead to a bad result in your product or candle or test candle. And that has been known to turn people off from the candle making experience because they're like, what did I do wrong? I don't know what I'm doing. I don't know how to do this. When in fact it was just the materials that they bought were so bad that the candle was doomed for failure from the beginning. So they are good to get you going and you can learn everything that it takes to get candle making, but just take that with a grain of salt when you end up with your end product. Now there are some higher end kits out there, I think. I've never bought the higher end kits, but those might be a little bit better with better vessels and maybe a better wax and a better wick quality. But for the most part, when you're starting out, people end up going for the lower end of the kits, $40, $50, $60, $70, something like that. And those are usually just trash. All right, let's go over the process. So there are many different styles of candle. We're gonna be talking about the container candle for this particular discussion. So first you're going to melt your wax. So you're going to weigh out however much wax you need. You're going to put it in your pouring pitcher and get it on the double boiler. Now you're going to want to heat that wax to the manufacturer's suggested temperature, which for soy wax is around 185 degrees, coconut waxes around 200 degrees, paraffin waxes again 185 degrees. Once that wax has come up to temperature and it's almost ready, that's when you're going to want to add your dye if you're using dye blocks or dye chips. You're going to want to add that while it's still heating so those particles can properly dissolve in the wax. Now that your wax is up to temperature, you can pull it off of the double boiler and add your fragrance oil. You can also add your liquid dye at this point too. You're going to go ahead and stir that wax for 1 to 2 minutes, properly combining the wax and the fragrance oil, and then carefully pour it into your vessel. You can then add your wick centering device. Although, I like to do it beforehand. With the one I have, you can actually do it beforehand. If you're using chopsticks or something, you can just go ahead and do it after the fact. All right, let's get into curing your candle. After you've poured your candle, let it sit just like that for about 24 hours. Then you can go ahead and remove your wick centering device and trim the wick. At this point, I also like to add a lid. If you don't have a lid for your vessel, that's okay, but lids keep your candle free from dust and debris. Now, cure times are controversial. Although they really shouldn't be. A lot of people confuse cure times for hot throw and not wick performance, when cure time is almost 100% for wick performance. Your wax has to be a certain hardness for you to get a proper wick test out of it. Cure times for paraffin are about 24 to 48 hours, although I like to go 3 days for that. If you're using a parasoy, I like 5 to 7 days cure time for a parasoy wax. And all other waxes like soy wax, coconut waxes, and all the blends in between that have vegetable waxes in them, 14 days cure time. And apparently one of the hardest things to do in the candle making business is wait for your candles to cure to test them. So here's a little pro tip. Go ahead and make 2 candles. One candle you set away and properly cure for the 14 days. The other candle you can go ahead and mess around with and play with and chop up and do whatever you want with. But that way you have, at least you have your real setup candle going and you're not sitting there agonizing over the wait time. All right guys, those are the things I think you should know when you're first starting out candle making. Go ahead and hit that like button, the subscribe button, and I'll catch you on the next one.